Hello and welcome to the Cantina of Comics.
On this episode, we're going to show you how to make a drink that will make a Bantha blush.
Plus, we're going to wrap up some Bounty Hunters story arc and go on a quest for the Lost Rings of Vol. Welcome to the Cantina of Comics. I'm Matt.
And I'm Kristi. Today we're going to show you how to make a very sweet drink called the Bantha Baileys Blast.
So what do we need to make a Bantha Baileys Blast?
Okay, so we're going to
I'm guessing it's going to have Baileys in it.
No Bantha, though.
No Bantha.
No.
Bantha in name only.
Yeah. So we fill our shaker halfway up with ice.
Okay.
And we're going to take 1 ounce. Actually, we're going to do 2 ounces of Baileys because we're making enough for two drinks.
Have you ever drunk Baileys from a shoe?
No.
Okay, like so two shot glasses of Baileys. Okay.
Oh. Here, will you open this?
Sure.
And then we're going to do 2 ounces of Amaretto.
Okay.
Liqueur.
Liqueur. That's from the French word meaning liqueur.
French.
Okay.
Jean-Luc Liqueur.
Oh, wait. Wrong franchise. Okay.
And then 2 ounces of Kahlua. This is going to be, you know how we talk about needing extra alcohol?
Yes.
Ooh, looks good. Okay, and then we're going to use whipping cream. It calls for half and half.
Okay.
But we're going to do whipping cream because that's what we have in the fridge.
That's what we have available.
And some of the recipes say half milk and half whipping cream. So you can make it however you'd like. And I'm sure if you want to make it skinny, you could do fat-free milk.
Okay.
Okay, so we're going to
shake it. Into the shaker.
I'm not very professional at this yet. Okay, so we're going to have to shake it for 30 seconds.
Okay.
Okay, and then we're going to pour through the strainer.
All right. Oh.
Looks so
yeah,
good.
Yeah, it does. Looks all well mixed.
All right. Shall I give
so.
It a try?
Okay, so it's just 4 ingredients, basically.
Yeah, really easy.
Okay, and it's supposed to have like a toffee flavor to
yeah,
it?
Yeah, it's a buttered toffee kind of a flavor.
Buttered toffee? So. Okay. Well, we asked you earlier, have you ever drunk Baileys from a shoe? I got my Star Wars Boba Fett shoe. Are you ready?
Why did you
do that? Ready? The Bantha Baileys Blast from a shoe.
That's good.
Oh, it's very sweet. Yeah. It's very sweet, and you have the intermixing of flavors, so your tongue is trying to decipher which one is which.
Yeah, I can taste some.
But tell your brain, just forget about that. Yeah. Just go with what you...
Just drink.
Just drink and enjoy. So that is a Bantha Baileys Blast.
Yes.
From a shoe. All right.
From a Boba Fett shoe.
Absolutely. You got to have the Star Wars Boba Fett shoe. Okay, coming up, we're talking Bounty Hunters, and we're talking Dr. Aphra. That is coming up next. And welcome back. Don't forget to click the subscribe button so that you don't miss a single video from Utini. We also have great videos from Emma, Jake, Nathan, along with episodes of the Living Force podcast and Legends Look Back. Click subscribe and the bell icon so that you don't miss a single video. Now, this week we're talking about Bounty Hunters number 5 and Dr. Aphra number 4. Let's go ahead and start with Bounty Hunters number 5. This is Galaxy's Deadliest Part 5, The High Cost of Revenge. This one was written by Ethan Sachs with the pencils by Paolo Villanelli and colors by Arif Peranto. Now in this issue, we're hoping to get some explanation as to why Boba Fett burst into the room and killed T'Anga. Instead, we open with a flashback of Nagano Lash as a child and how she became an orphan. Then we jump back to the present as Boba Fett is duking it out with the hunter Valance while Nagano Lash is trying to protect Kadalaya, the child who could unite the Mourner's Wail and Unbroken Clans. We get a nice little slugfest as another player enters the game, Vukora of the Unbroken Clan, who is after Nagano Lash as well. Fett finally has the drop on Lash and lands a killing blow when a part of the ship conveniently falls in between them, separating the two of them. Fett takes off and Valance tries to rescue Lash, but the ship they're on is disintegrating, and so Valance has to leave Lash to die, but he does get away with the child, Kadalaya. And now, here are some quick takes on the issue. Now, as much as I love Boba Fett and Bounty Hunters in the Star Wars universe, my expectations were set pretty high for this series from Marvel. Yeah, maybe I shouldn't have set them so high. Now, one of the issues that plagues this issue and the series so far is that there's a lot of jumping back and forth in the timeline. Now in this issue, there were a couple of really cool Boba Fett visor reflections. And towards the end of the issue, we do get to see where Valance gets his oversized rifle from. Now let's head over to Dr. Aphra number 4. This is Fortune and Fate Part 4, The Deal, written by Alyssa Wrong with pencils by Marika Cresta and colors by Rochelle Rosenberg. And we found out in the last issue just who the traitor was. Just Lucky. Now, Lucky is in possession of one of the two rings of Vol, the one that grants unlimited fortune, and he leaves Aphra and the crew trapped underground. Now, Aphra, Black K, Deta Yad, Professor Oka, and the droid TA-418 have to explore to make their way out. Well, they manage to make their way out of the caverns, and within sight of their ship, when wouldn't you know it, Baron Tag's fleet takes it out. Now that's just plain rude. Now Lucky and Tag's goons meet up with the Baron on Canto Bite, but since Lucky only showed up with one of the two rings and without Dr. Oka, he's only gonna get paid 1/3 of the reward fee. Then we learn what Tag is holding over the head of Just Lucky and what made Lucky turn on his friends. We then return to Aphra and the group as they find a ship and make a plan to confront Tag. And then they're captured. Now, here are my quick takes on Dr. Aphra, issue number 4. This issue is full of conveniences. It's convenient that the trapped explorers were able to find an exit that was right next to their ship. It was convenient that after Tag's ships destroyed the Archangel and the entire city of Vol, that Aphra was able to find an intact High Republic ship in good working condition. And it was convenient that Aphra was able to track Tag to where he was staying on Canto Bite. Overall, this issue quickly moves things into their conclusion, which is in the next issue. Now, I would love to hear what you have to say about Bounty Hunters number 5 and Dr. Aphra number 4. Go to the Utini group on Discord and click on the EU comics to discuss. Okay, we've got a new game for you. It's kind of like a game show premise. It's okay. Called Higher Lower. What I have is thank you very much, Price is Right model. What I have here is I don't call it classic, but it is a Star Wars item that was available on the Star Tours at Disneyland and Disney World of, as you can see, Mickey Mouse and Minnie Mouse dressed up as Luke and Leia. It is a bank, it's a piggy bank. So it's a plastic, it's not ceramic.
It's in perfect condition.
It's as close to perfect as you can get. Now this was released in 2009, so it's only about 11 years old. But this was before Disney purchased Star Wars.
Okay.
So you've got the Star Tours link there, but it has a whole lot more significance now that Disney owns Star Wars. So I'm gonna give you a price point, and then you tell me if it's higher or lower. I got the price point off of eBay. If it's higher and lower than the number I give you.
Okay.
So I'm gonna give you $20.
Higher.
You think it's higher than $20.
Yeah.
It is lower.
No way.
It is $14 on eBay.
What?
Yeah. Now I'm gonna,
Now,
do you think I paid higher or lower than $14
for
this?
I'm actually thinking you paid higher than $14.
I paid lower.
You did?
I got this at a flea market for $2.
Wow.
So it has appreciated, 1,000% plus? Yeah, $14. Wow. This is my kids' college retirement.
Right. This is your inheritance, Garrett.
There you go. And Olivia, because
they have to split
that $12 profit. All right, so we showed you how to make the Bantha Baileys Blast from a shoe.
And it's pretty tasty.
And it is pretty tasty, and I could get kind of used to these. That's, you can just barely taste the alcohol part of it, but it's very...
I'm thinking it'll be good during the holidays.
So ah, there you go. Nice. So you're serving up your holiday meeting, if you do get together with your family for the holidays, right. Or if you need them to, if you need a little extra tolerance drink, so, you know, having the in-laws in or whatever. So there you go. Well, thanks for watching the Cantina of Comics, and don't forget, you can catch all of our episodes on the Utini YouTube page. Lots of other really cool videos on there too, so be sure to check out that. And until then, we'll see you next time on the Cantina of Comics. And welcome to the Cantina of Comics.
You're Matt.
I'm Matt.
And I'm Kristi.
Why do you forget that, or why do me forget that part? It's just my name, you know.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay, try to. And welcome to the Cantina of Comics. I'm Matt.
And I'm Kristi. Today we're going to show you how to make a very sweet drink.
Have you ever drunk Baileys from a shoe? I got my Star Wars Boba Fett shoe. Are you ready? The Bantha Baileys Blast from a shoe. But the ship they're on is disintegrating, and so Valance has to leave Lash to die and gets away with the child Caldea. Caldelia. Caldelia. Caldelia.